gems. I crack myself up. Just a little scientific humor there for you.
Lewis, stop it.
What? Who says science can't be fun?
Of course science can be fun, but we don't have to insult our audience right out of the gate. I think you are quite finished. It's time for the greatest scientist of all time to take center stage.
That is very kind of you, but I probably do not require an introduction.
You? She was talking about me. I am Archimedes. Of course, you already knew that, I'm sure. After all, I am without a doubt the first and greatest scientist, mathematician, physicist, engineer, inventor, and astronomer of all time.
Well, you certainly have gotten the theory of wind down, as in wind, as in hot air.
Again, if you are through.
Yes, I believe I was about to introduce myself. I am Albert Einstein, Nobel Prize award-winning scientist and the greatest scientist of all time. My theory of relativity changed the course of history.
Well, that's the road we're going down. I am Marie Curie, groundbreaking scientist in the study of radioactivity. I won the Nobel Prize not once, but twice. Not only that, the prizes were awarded in two different fields, chemistry and physics. No other scientist has ever done that.
Hello, hello, Isaac Newton here. No Newton, no telescope.
And thank you for that invention. I am Sally Ride. When I was young, I looked through a telescope, set my sight on the stars, and worked hard to become the youngest American astronaut to travel space.
Hello, Louis Pasteur here, germ fighter, inventor of pasteurization, and all-around funny man.
Perhaps your jokes are actually masking a deep psychological problem. I'm Dr. Sigmund Freud. Should we talk about the relationship with your mother?
Hey, it's not right to bring someone's mother into this.
No! No! No!
Who in the pray tell are you?
I am Janaya Whitfield, and I too am a scientist.
You? A scientist?
Yes. In fact, all of us are scientists, and we're learning all sorts of fascinating things about science.
Well, I did like that song you were singing.
Rockets, rockets, all you got to do is rocket. Yes, that's catchy, but do you know what it means?
Of course, no matter where you go in the world, any rock you pick up will fall into one of three main classifications. Tell them about it, scientists.
An igneous rock is when lava or magma cools and becomes a solid. 65% of the Earth's surface is covered in igneous rocks.
Sedimentary!
Sedimentary rocks form when various particles of other things settle on down under pressure.
Sedimentary rocks are where we're most likely to find fossils.
Metamorphic rocks do just what their name suggests. They morph.
They start out as igneous or sedimentary rocks, but the earth, gases, temperature, and pressure warp them into something new. It's intriguing.
Yes, intriguing, but can you tell me what the laws of motion say about this rock?
Unless something acts on it, that rock is going to stay right there in your hand. An object at rest will stay at rest.
But if you decide to throw it, an object in motion will stay in motion until another force like wind resistance and gravity acts on it.
Well done, young scientist. That was very good.
Archimedes, these students might know something after all.
I don't know. What could you know that I don't know?
Well, the Earth is round for one thing.
Oh.
your day, I believe the world was described in terms of earth, water, and air. Today, when scientists describe the state of matter, we refer to solids, liquids, and gases.
Tell me more.
The lungs, the main organ in my respiratory system. My heart and blood vessels make up my circulatory system.
My brain is the control center for it all, sending and receiving signals from my nervous system.
My glands work together to make up my endocrine system.
Miss Blackwell, may I be?
I need a...
the excretory system.
Interesting. I wonder what his mother would have to say about that.
Thank you. more like a big steak.
I'm starving. I'm so hungry I could eat a whole horse.
Oh, come on. You're not really going to eat a horse, are you?
No, that's just what my mother always says when she's hungry.
His mother. I'm noticing a pattern.
From being consumed.
Tell me more.
Well, the chameleon, for example, its skin color can change rapidly to match its surroundings in an effort to stay hidden.
Yes, and the hedgehog grows into a ball when it is in danger. Its hairs form a prickly protection. And the skunk, it's not fast, but it doesn't have to be.
There we go again, right back to gases.
At least this time, Dr. Freud didn't talk about anyone's mother. Unaware what photosynthesis is. It is simply the process in green plants by which carbohydrates are synthesized by water using that as an energy source. The byproduct released is the most often oxygen, is of course what we breathe. There will be a test.
Life.
Maybe someday we will become great scientists like you.
Remember, students, as you strive to learn all you possibly can,
keep working hard.
Learn to adapt.
Wash your hands regularly.
Reach for the stars.
Be nice to your mother.
And most of all,
keep rocking.